Welcome back again into the world of the apostolate for family consecration. We have with us once again Father Robert Fox, the author of our book, Fatima Today, and Dr. Burns Seeley. Father, you know, diving right into this, probably everybody always thinks about the secret of Fatima, you know, and it's amazing. They don't even know what the public message is, but they all want to know what wasn't supposed to be revealed to the public. What is the... What are your comments about the secret?
Because in July is when the Fatima secret was given. Mm-hmm. And whenever I hear about people being so curious about that secret, you know, secrets were given to St. Bernadette of Lourdes, too. And she went to the grave without having revealed, and you never hear people getting excited about that. And but we do know two parts of the secret. And Lucia was not permitted by God to tell them to some years later. They're in her memoirs. And memoirs written 1935, 1937, and then two other parts in 1941. And the first part of the secret was the terrible vision of hell. And of course, this just really overwhelmed them. The fire and animals appearing like a terrible beast, and souls being thrown around in this fire like sparks in a great conflagration. And she said it was so terrible that if they had not been promised, they would go to heaven. She thinks they would have died on the spot.
By the way, and, Father, when you say this is a secret when it was revealed, but it could be revealed at a later time.
It could be revealed at a later time. They were not able to reveal it for a long time. And this was also the beginning of great spiritual transformation for all three. And Sister Lucy in the 1940s writes, "And I hear people say we ought not teach children about hell because it will frighten them. And yet heaven did not hesitate to show this terrible vision to three little children, one who was hardly more than 6 years old." And the second part of the secret is that God wants devotion established in the world to the Immaculate Heart of His Mother. And that, of course, as you know, you had me interviewed me on a book on what is meant by the Immaculate Heart of Mary. That's something we just really keep going and going on, because that's the totality of our believing our faith and living our faith. Now, it's a third part that people are curious about. Right. That's the one that has not been revealed, and that was only intended for the Pope. And I get letters and I get pamphlets that people have written. First of all, some claiming to be what the secret is, which is fictitious. And then others claiming the Pope has an obligation. He is failing the church. He is failing the world because he does not reveal that to us. Mm-hmm. It has always been said that that was for the Pope.
That's right. Yeah.
However, Dr. Alonso, who died recently, the official historian of Fatima, he's written over 10,000 pages, had access to every documentation on Fatima. I interviewed him more than once. He told me that he is certain of the contents of the secret. And I said, "You know the Fatima secret?" He says, as a theologian, eminent theologian in Europe he was, "You must make a distinction. I know it in general, not in specifics." Now, Bishop John Venancio, who took the secret to the Pope, he told me, "I had the secret in my possession. I had it in an envelope, and I could have opened it if I wanted to, but I did not want to take that responsibility upon myself." He said it was on like a normal size sheet of paper, folded. But he said, "I did do this. I held it up to the sun in the window," and he says, "It's very short." So when you see about every 2 years coming out of Europe and then it gets circulated in the United States and it goes on paragraph after paragraph after paragraph and they claim specifically cardinal against cardinal, et cetera, et cetera. And And these are fictitious, and it does great harm. So I said to Dr. Alonso, Clarician priest, historian of Fatima, so tell me, what is, if you know the Fatima secret in general, tell me, what is it and how do you know it? Mm-hmm. And he says, well, from structuralism. What is structuralism? Well, the same method that biblical scholars use when they interpret the Bible. There are many things in the Bible that are explicit. There are many things that are implicit. Because of what is said, we can conclude what is not said. This follows. And so you read what Lucia writes in the July accounts. And then there's dash, 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 a part that we aren't told about, the third secret. Third part of the secret. And then it says, but in Portugal, the dogma of faith will always be preserved. So this implies in some other parts of the world, the dogma of faith will be disturbed in the hearts of people. So he says, we are living the third part of the secret. The destruction to the faith, the dissension to papal teachings, people being confused, what does the Catholic Church teach when we know very well it has not changed any of its doctrines of faith and morals? This is the third secret. We are living it. And this is how the official historian of Fatima interprets the third part of the secret.
It has to be, you know, because we're living through such an extraordinary age of division, and when we came from such an age of unity, when I was young in grammar school, and there was, you would go to one priest and you would say the same as another, today we have...
Every priest and every sister said the same. Once in a while, you get an old grouch among them, mm-hmm. but they still taught the same thing.
Yeah, right.
And I believe with the triumph of the Immaculate Heart, we're going to get back to that unity.
Mm-hmm. But that's why we in the Apostolate, Father, insist, and of course I know you would agree with us 100%, is since this is so much the case, we must go to the Holy Father to know what the Church really teaches today.
Yes, the Pope is the man of unity. This is the reason Jesus gave us the Pope. The rock of our faith to keep us one in the faith. And when we study the Fatima message, the Pope appears so very, very often. And the mm-hmm. Father, this saintly priest whose cause, Father Cruz, has been introduced for canonization in Portugal, he would tell the children, you have received a very, very great grace, and you must thank God for this grace. And he told them about the Holy Father. And from then on, they were always praying for the Pope. And Jacinta never said a rosary, but what she would add, three extra Hail Marys for the Holy Father. And this is what I was thinking about Bishop Sheen. Mm-hmm. He said, the day will come. He had a great understanding of communism and the confusion to the faith that would be sown in the world. The day will come, he said this over 30 years ago, he becomes so confused, and like the Antichrist, there is Christ, there mm-hmm. is Christ, and who do you follow, who do you believe in? And he said, when that day comes, you must listen to the Pope. Right. The Pope is the one who will speak for Jesus Christ. When you hear people saying, this is Christian teaching, that is Christian teaching, you may follow this voice, you may follow this voice. Now, this is before the day of mm-hmm. many dissenters among, well, let's say some of the theologians. Mm-hmm. Bishop Sheen was saying that then already. When that day comes, follow the Pope.
Didn't Our Lady say in one, or at least one of the apparitions, that the Holy Father would suffer a great deal?
Yes, yes, that's in July. That's in July. And she said... and she foretold a greater war, persecution to the Church, persecution to the Pope. There will be hunger. But to prevent this, I will come to ask for the consecration of Russia by the Pope and the clerical consecration, all the bishops of the world, and for the communions of reparation on First Saturdays. Now, we hear I see articles, I get letters, throwing the whole burden upon the Pope. The reason Russia is not being converted because they haven't done the collegial consecration in the right way. But if they study this, it's not only the consecration by the Pope and the bishops. It's also something upon us. Eucharistic reparation, especially on First Saturdays. And when she says, to prevent this, I will come to ask for communions of reparation on First Saturdays. She doesn't say five then. When she actually does come, December 10th, 1925, she does promise that those who do those four things of First Saturdays, at least five times in a row, she will see that they die in a state of grace. Now, I interpret that as a bonus for you as an individual.
Right. It's not to stop after five. It's just to get you going.
But for the whole world, mm-hmm. for the conversion of Russia, every first Saturday should be a special day.
Well, there's something I didn't realize until maybe a year or so ago, that Our Lady, well, she certainly revealed this to the children in 1917, actually, and probably much earlier even than St. Pius X, he had promoted First Saturday's communions of reparation.
Yes, I understand setting aside Saturday as a special day of Mary, and for a purpose like this, extends even further back than that.
Mm-hmm. I'm not at all surprised.
And today we're faced with such a problem where many parishes aren't even having Saturday Masses because of the Sunday anticipated Masses on Saturday. Some parishes just are not having Saturday Masses.
I get a lot of letters like that. But what can we do?
Yeah.
the question, will my Saturday night Mass fulfill my Sunday obligation and also take care of First Saturday? And
it would, wouldn't it, if they went to church on Sunday then?
If they went on Sunday. But, yeah. I mean, and then, well, a lot of them don't go on Sunday.
Oh, no, well, then it wouldn't.
And, yeah, well, I said, I think Our Lady meant this as a sacrifice, a reparation, not to cut corners.
That's right. So if, let's just say a parish doesn't have Saturday morning, or they can't get to a Saturday morning Mass, they decide to go to the Saturday evening Mass for Sunday, but then they also go on Sunday.
Yes.
That would count as the...
Now, unless you're in rural areas, mission parishes, where then you have a situation that's different, and maybe that's the only Mass they can go to. Then I would say only for those people can they do it jointly.
That's right. Yeah. That's right, because it is a sacrifice. But to see that so First Saturday is a very important day, and what she was saying she wanted in First Saturday is to come to church to receive our Lord in reparation for the sins that offend the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Now that's a kicker there, and most people don't want to do that. You know,
they must be all four of these things must be done in reparation.
So it's the Rosary, it's meditation, it's the receiving of Holy Communion, and making reparation to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and going to confession within a reasonable period of time was originally asked for on Saturday.
And it's interesting to see when our Lucy asked our Lord, can they make the First Communion 8 days later? yes, even more time, but they must be in the state of grace when they receive Communion.
Right.
And it's really great when you study all of these things, how it reaffirms our
everything
the way we were brought up.
That's right.
You know,
it
don't go to Communion unless you're in a state of grace.
That's right.
You got to go to confession first if your conscience tells you a serious sin.
Right.
These things all come out in Fatima.
I think First Saturday, see, we have a videotape with the Soul of the Rosary, and it has two parts to it. Each tape has, one's a joyful, one's a sorrowful, one's a glorious. And the first part is the short family version where we just announce the meditation, you know, the mystery of the Rosary, and we say the Rosary with picture for each Hail Mary. But then the second part of it, and some people have written back, hey, this is very similar to the first part, well, we wanted that. Mm-hmm. We just have 3 minutes of meditative reading between each decet then.
What was in chapel this morning?
That was the...
Is that the shorter form?
That was the shorter form. The longer form has, between each decet, there's a little 3-minute reading with pictures that explains the mystery, a narration.
Well, boy, I've been saying the Rosary for years, and I found that helped me this morning in chapel.
It was a beautiful picture for each Mary. And we're asking now that be shown in churches, be beautiful for First Saturday.
Yes.
And confessions could be heard during the time the rosary is said, and then Mass could be offered after the confessions. And what a beautiful first Saturday service that would be. And
we're starting to see. Is it possible to get that without being a part of the
whole apostolate? Oh, yes, that's for sale to the general public, yeah.
Great.
And it is a, and Trinity Communications can sell it too, so you can let them know.
I'll let them
put it in their catalog. Yeah. It's a good. But we were thinking of the first Saturday communion of reparation very specifically when we put that out, because so few people really, when Our Lady said meditate for 15 minutes,
yes,
they don't do that. And now she's placing so much emphasis on meditation. I remember when Cardinal Odie was here, we were talking about another apparition that we were questioning, and they were asking, it was asking for 15 decades of the rosary, and Cardinal Odie was saying again, it's the meditation, it's not the quantity.
Yes.
And that's what Fatima
said. And we must have the intention of reparation to Immaculate Mary at the time.
That's right.
Because remember, Lucia asked our Lord, wonder if they went to confession for First Saturday and forgot to have the intention that this is in reparation of Immaculate Mary. And our Lord said, the next time they go to confession, they can do that, form the intention. That really struck me, that he loves his mother so much, and he wants us to venerate. He has put the peace of the world and the peace of the church in her hands, and he's saying, you're going to do it my way. It's going to come only she can give this peace, and it's got to be reparation to my mother. So if you go to confession for First Saturday and you forgot to have the intention in your heart, the next time you go to confession, well, even if it's 2 or 3 weeks later, you still go. But when you go, I am doing this in reparation to the Immaculate Mary. You don't have to tell the priest that.
No, you just
but you have to have it in your heart.
Right. So it is so important, you're right, Father, that our Lord is literally placing nuclear war, world peace, peace in our families, on this prerequisite that we really practice this first Saturday communion of reparation with all of its facets, and that we truly live a consecrated life.
You know, peace. Now, she came as a lady of peace. The angel said, I am the angel of peace. When Pope Paul VI went to Fatima, 1967, he had read the Fatima Secret before he went. And if you notice, he gave two reasons why he was going to Fatima: to pray for peace in the world, peace in the church. Now, I think we have to look at Our Lady, the message of Fatima, living the message of Fatima, bringing peace. That means not only peace in the world of nation against nation, but peace in souls, peace in family, peace with God. I think we are thinking only in terms of people not dropping bombs and shooting.
Right.
Oh, there is so little peace.
It has to start with
right here.
Father, could I ask for a point of clarification? When Our Lady asked for 15 minutes of meditation on First Saturday and the mysteries of the Rosary, is that to be over and above the ordinary recitation of the Rosary that we would do on other days?
You know, I asked Bishop Venancio that question, and the First Saturdays was approved and promulgated by the first Bishop of Fatima, Bishop de Silva, and this is how he answered that. Bishop Venancio, the second bishop, answered that. He said, Bishop de Silva, first Bishop of Fatima, who promulgated the First Saturday, said that they can be combined. In other words, you don't have to say the Rosary and afterwards spend an additional 15 minutes. He said they could be combined. How I say the Rosary, he said, I meditate on each decade, each mystery for about 5 minutes without saying the Hail Marys. Just meditate on a mystery. Then I say the 10 Hail Marys, where I keep my mind on the mystery. Then I spend another 5 minutes. So he satisfied his conscience that he was taking care of that. But I think the one who really has authority here is the bishop who approved of it. Bishop de Silva said that they could be combined, but you better get in the 15 minutes of meditation and not just spend the time saying 50 Hail Marys.
So the importance is the meditation. I think Our Lady is teaching us with this promise of salvation there, really, if we do it for five consecutive months, is that meditation is really the heart of the rosary. Because Paul VI wrote his apostolic exhortation, Marius Cultus, and he actually said that it borders on superstition if you don't bring in the... Very powerful words
well,
for Pope
said,
to say
a vain
that,
repetition of prayers.
Yeah, I mean, if you're just rattling it off...
I never thought of that before, where he said meditation on the mysteries is the soul of the rosary.
Mm-hmm.
The litany, the Our Father's a Hail Mary, is the body. And if you say the body, without the meditation, without the soul, it's like a corpse. It's like a dead corpse without its soul.
Mm-hmm.
And do you know, the last two parishes that I have gone into, middle-aged people, and I preached on the proper way of saying a rosary, middle-aged people, even catechetical instructors said, I never knew before that you're supposed to meditate on the mysteries and you say the rosary. No wonder many people can't get the rosary. I wonder if there isn't 80% of the Catholics in the United States that do not know.
They look on it more as a penance. It's more of a penance than meditation. But if you meditate, it's so warm and beautiful and orderly.
It's living the gospel.
Because we know that Our Lady of Fatima stressed the proper praying of the rosary. Did you know that Our Lady showed Jacinta in their parish church of Fatima 15 tableaus, taught this little 7-year-old girl how to pray the rosary properly by showing them 15 tableaus, pictures, like you're showing on your screen there. And in the future, they are going to, in honor of that, they are going to be painting 15 representations in the Fatima church of the 15 mysteries. So what you're doing there is exactly how Our Lady taught Jacinta how to meditate on the mysteries.
Because the soul of the rosary videos that we have, it's not a product. It really is playing a major role in fulfilling the Fatima message. So when the family comes together on the first Saturday of every month for the longer version, it's 15 minutes longer, but they're listening to an explanation of the mystery of the rosary 3 minutes between each decade.
Now, if somebody wanted to order that for the parish, what it precisely is the title they'd
ask
for.
Soul of the Rosary, that's all it is. We call it Soul of the Rosary.
Soul of the Rosary.
Yeah. One tape has both versions.
Yeah, and there's three tapes to the set. There's one tape with Joyful, and it has two parts to it, the family short version, and then the First Saturday version.
The longer, shorter version is all in one cassette.
Yeah, one tape. They have two rosaries on one cassette, you know. And it really is...
I've got to get that.
And it's not a... It's just not another item. It's an absolute must. I think people don't realize that this first Saturday, because more and more people are sleeping in on Saturdays. You know, being when Our Lady made that promise, Saturday was work day. Everybody got out and worked there every day, just like every other day. But today, it's like a Sunday. They sleep in.
Yeah, well, it's
so it is a sacrifice to really get out and go to Mass on Saturday, first Saturday. So we had a priest in Milwaukee that Mrs. Pryor told us about that is having a first Saturday now in devotion, and he's going to have Mass and confessions and the rosary and the meditations, and it's going to be on a first Saturday fulfilling what Our Lady asked. Now, when we start this videotape can just make it so much easier. Now, in a church setting, they might not want to set up a television set. They can just play the audio tape, you know, in the mystery there, the speaking of it.
Much more effective with the pictures.
But if it's not set up, they can have the audio tape played, and we have an audio tape version.
You know, I have always prayed the rosary by forming a mental image of whatever the mystery is.
Right.
And the ones you showed this morning were much more beautiful, the image I've been forming in my mind.
Well, the nice thing about it is as the children see these pictures, then when they're saying the rosary on their own, those pictures pop back in their minds. And so I think the Soul of the Rosary program is so vital. And but we're asking our members to remember that First Saturday, a communion of reparation, is not just another pious devotion. Like the church has, you know, literally thousands of pious devotions.
Mm-hmm.
This is one that we have to practice if we're going to bring peace to our time. It's not one of those options. And very few
according
people
to Our Lady
talk
of Fatima,
about it.
Every time, pray the rosary every day.
That's right.
And it's not superstition. I mean,
she didn't suggest it. She said, do it.
That's right. I think this is a good point in breaking now, because again, as we read Father Fox's book, we're reading a formula for peace in our own families, in our own neighborhoods, and in the world. And it seems like the Holy Spirit really guided us into talking about the First Saturday Communion of Reparation And we're going to be talking about consecration in the next time. What is consecration? What did the Holy Father, did he really fulfill the requests of Fatima by consecrating the world to the Immaculate Heart of Mary? And I think this is one of the things we had an interview with the Pope's Secretary, Monsignor McGee, and talked about this very directly, too, and we'll be sharing that with you. And I think this is, again, to make a commitment to practice the First Saturday Communion of Reparation, to offer your rosary, your Holy Communion, your sacrifices for that day in reparation for the sins that offend the Immaculate Heart of Mary, to go to Mass, to receive our Lord in Holy Communion for that intention, to meditate for 15 minutes on the rosary. And it's a perfect day to really go to confession, to make that your minimum of at least once a month. Normally in the apostolate, our members that are going to confession weekly, because this is grace that is needed truly to live this God-centered life. It's not a requirement, but we recommend it. We'll be back in 60 minutes. Thank you.